With Ebola concerns mounting across the U.S., some are blaming the Centers for Disease Control for failing to do enough to protect Americans. Shockingly, liberals are blaming the Republican Party for the CDC's problems. For example, Barbara Streisand says the government cannot prevent Ebola because of GOP budget cuts. But it turns out the CDC and the National Institutes of Health both have plenty of money. The problem is they've wasted billions of dollars on outrageous projects. And joining us now with more is Dan Gaynor, the Vice President of Business and Culture at the Media Research Center. Welcome, Dan.
Thank you very much.
Well, first of all, is the trouble at the CDC the fault of Republicans? I mean, my understanding is the CDC and NIH already have massive budgets, don't they?
Well, of course they do. And the GOP cut their funding is absurd, and that's actually from the Washington Post. Their fact checker called it exactly that. If you go back to look at the big funding, they got a huge increase when George Bush was president. From 2000 to 2004, the infectious disease areas went from $1.8 billion to $4.5 billion. It's more than 100% increase. It's just outlandish to claim this, but it's not too surprising. The left tends to make literally everything a political issue.
Your Media Research Center has published 15 ways the NIH and CDC wasted taxpayer money. Tell us about the top most wasteful project, Dan.
Well, this is when they spent $15 billion on basically marketing and promoting issues. This is all PR feel-good stuff. This is the kind of thing that ordinary companies, when times get tough, they cut in budgets. Nevertheless, the left is going out there complaining about, the GOP's, they're the ones who cut the CDC. The CDC both the CDC and NIH have been fraught with disease problems. They can't even handle their own pathogens correctly. And yet everybody wants to blame GOP.
Well, there are a number of bizarre studies involving everything from drunk monkeys to overweight lesbians. Tell us about some of these.
Well, actually, my favorite is rabbit massage. That one got $386,000. The four-year push to analyze why overweight lesbians get drunk. The look at analyzing drunken monkeys. The push by both the CDC and the NIH into pursuing aggressively ways to control guns. The CDC and NIH have lost their way, and they've become, just the pot at the end of the rainbow for researchers who can't find other ways to fund their high-end lifestyle.
Has the CDC, Dan, really made it a priority to work on a vaccine for Ebola?
Not enough of one. I mean, that's something they've been working on for 13 years. Clearly not a number one priority for them because they haven't had success. Now, their scientific success is never guaranteed, but if it was really a focus, all these other things would have been set aside. They would have set aside the marketing and the monkeys and decided to pursue actual science. Instead, they're spending money on propaganda and trying to control how we live, not what is a real danger to us.
All right, Dan Gaynor of the Media Research Center. Thanks for being with us, sir.
Thank you.